So let's start. So last lecture we were looking at encoder decoder models, and we saw that a bunch of problems from different domains and different modalities, images, text, videos and so on. And even this cross-modal or multimodal applications where you are taking a video and trying to describe it. So video is one modality, description is text, which is another modality and so on. We were able to propose models for all of these using this encoder decoder architecture. And then we motivated this attention mechanism where we said that encoder decoder is trying to do this silly thing where it tries to encode the entire input once, and that's not how humans do it. We do this back and forth thing where at every time step, if we are trying to produce a translation or a single word in the translation, we just focus on certain words in the input sentence and kind of ignore the others and so on. So the attention mechanism, which is this bunch of equations that you see here, that allowed you a neural way of modeling attention. And the key thing to note here is that there is no supervision for the attention. No one actually tells us that this is the portion of the text which is important at time step t. But this still works better because this is a better modeling choice. And I gave you that bicycle analogy. And so it's a better modeling choice. So you're able to, no one has given you these supervisions, but you still have more parameters in the model to learn this kind of a behavior. And then we also saw that we could actually visualize these attention weights, and from some experiments, from some papers, we saw that it actually learned some meaningful attentions. In the particular case on the figure on the right hand side, so the one that clearly shows that for a monotonic kind of a translation scenario between English and French, most of the attention weights are along the diagonal, and that's exactly what you would expect, right? So that's where we ended.